Do you want to know what we did to rank twice on Google with a YouTube video and a blog post? The answer is schema markups. What is this and how can you implement it? We will talk about it in this video. Hello and welcome to the Tubics YouTube channel. I'm Jan Fassbender from SoGeht YouTube. The big search engines like Google, Bing or Yahoo have all been supporting video schema markups for almost 6 years now, but still a lot of companies don't know about them. And that's a shame because the use of schemas is one of the best ways to support search engines to understand the content of your page better. Google, of course, tries to automatically figure out what's happening on your page, but you can help Google by providing extra information via these schema markups. You can provide information like a video description, the video URL, its length, the upload date, and so on by marking your video up with a video object. This can greatly improve your chances to rank on Google and rank on Google faster. And you can not only rank on the Google homepage, but also in Google Videos, Google Images, and on Google Discovery. The reason why schema markups can do this is because Google can understand them way better than plain text. If you embed a video in your blog post, you will appear in the Google search results faster. And although YouTube itself marks up these embedded videos, it takes longer than if you mark them up yourself, and you will appear even faster on the Google results. The great thing is that you can now rank twice on Google, once with your video in the video carousel and a second time with the blog post, which in return leads to more presence and a higher share of voice. What should you include in your schema? Well, there are different types of schemas. There are not only schemas for videos, but also for recipe, for reviews, and so on. You can find out more about schemas on schema.org. But in this video, we want to talk about video schemas. So what should you include in your video schema? There are four required properties that you need to include in your video object, otherwise Google might not be able to extract any information out of it. So you should definitely include a description, a name, the thumbnail URL, and the upload date. And then there are some recommended properties that you can see here. You do not need to include all of them, but you can definitely include them to add more information for Google. What we use are the name, the description, the content URL, the thumbnail URL, the upload date, and the publish date. If you include this information, Google can get a better understanding of your video. Once you chose the relevant markups, you need to deploy the code to your website. And there are multiple ways to do this. Option number one, and also the option we are using, is to embed it in the HTML of your website. The JSON-LD schema is formatted as a script that you can put into your head or your body of your website. You will probably need to talk to your developer for this task. Option number two is to use the Google Tag Manager. This is especially useful if you're already familiar with using it and if it's more complicated to get the developers to implement the changes on the website. Option number three is to use your content management system or use plugins for your content management system. And this is probably the easiest and most user-friendly way to do it, but also the most complicated to explain because there are so many different systems and so many different plugins that it works differently for each and everyone. There's no one universal solution here, and you would still probably need to combine multiple. But here are some examples what you can use. After implementing, you should check if your site has rich results. To do it, go to this URL. We have also put it in the video description so you can click on it. In the Google Search Console, under Enhancements, you can click on Video, and there you can see if there are any errors with your site and if your video markup is working as intended. As a result, you will see both your YouTube video and your blog post on Google. Very important, you need one blog post with a schema markup for every video. A question you might ask yourself now is, will YouTube count the views of this embedded video? The short answer is yes. The long answer is not every view. YouTube will only count views longer than 30 seconds. And if your video is embedded and on autoplay, YouTube will not count the view. If you want to learn more about not only how to rank on Google, but also to rank on YouTube, check out this video. We will see each other in the next video. That's it for me. Bye, Jan.